Hello everyone, welcome to Rasayan. So students, in this lecture we'll be talking about nomenclature of hydrocarbons. We'll be learning how we are going to name different type of hydrocarbons. What is hydrocarbon? सबसे पहले तो हमें ये समझना होगा. Okay, so the first thing which all we need to understand is what is hydrocarbon. अगर आप ध्यान दें on this word hydrocarbon. Now this word hydrocarbon is made from two words, that is hydrogen and carbon. So hydrocarbons are basically compounds of hydrogen and carbon. In this lecture we're talking about only compounds of hydrogen and carbon, and we'll get basic understanding of entire hydrocarbons. So now these hydrocarbons are basically classified as saturated hydrocarbons, and unsaturated hydrocarbons. Okay, now why we are calling it as saturated and this is unsaturated? Because no addition or reaction can take place in your saturated hydrocarbon, but addition reaction can take place in unsaturated hydrocarbon. Now when you hear this word saturated, unsaturated, unsaturated and saturated solution comes in my mind, which tells us all about more solute cannot be added at a specific temperature in a particular solution if it's saturated. It can be added if it is unsaturated. So that's similar to this only, that in saturated hydrocarbon you won't be able to add more atoms in that particular compound. Okay, so that is how we understand saturated hydrocarbon and unsaturated hydrocarbon. Now we are calling it as saturated hydrocarbon. तो यहाँ पे हमें समझना पड़ेगा कि आप saturated hydrocarbon जो पढ़ते हो वो होता है alkane. This alkane contain carbon-carbon single bond. Remember, there is only a single covalent bond and alkane. ठीक है, दो वैलेंसीज आर सेटिस्फाइड. अगर दो कार्बन के पीछे बॉन्ड है तो वैलेंसीज इसकी पूरी सेटिस्फाइड होगी, बाकी जगह पे क्या होंगे, हाइड्रोकार्बन्स होने वाले हैं. ठीक है, अनसैचुरेटेड की अगर मैं बात करूँ तो दे आर क्लासिफाइड इन अल्किन्स एंड अल्काइन्स. नाउ In the case of alkenes, we have carbon-carbon double bond. And in the case of alkyne, we have carbon-carbon triple bond. Okay? Valences are satisfied accordingly. So, suppose if we have this only two carbon alkene, this is how valences is satisfied. If we have two carbon alkyne, this is how valences is satisfied. So, here you can see, guys, how alkane, alkene, and alkynes are studied. Yeah, they are basically studied as hydrocarbon. One is saturated and other two is unsaturated. Why they are unsaturated? Because by removing this double bond, we can add more atoms. Okay. So these pi bond removal are possible. An addition of more atoms are possible in unsaturated hydrocarbons, which we'll be seeing in an upcoming series of these lectures, how this addition reaction takes place. Right now, we are focusing on nomenclature. So first of all, we will be taking saturated hydrocarbon. We're talking about how these particular compounds are named. Okay. So now, discussing the case of saturated hydrocarbon, one thing is very clear with all of us that it contains carbon-carbon single bond, and they are represented by a general formula of CN H2N plus 2. This is the general formula of saturated hydrocarbon alkane. When I say saturated hydrocarbon, I'm talking about alkane. Now, while writing the name of saturated hydrocarbon, that is alkane, we use primary suffix as ane. You all know that. Okay. So we're taking the cases one by one. सबसे पहले हम बात करते हैं मीथेन की. दिस इज योर मीथेन. देखिए एक कार्बन एटम है. अब देखिए यहाँ पे आप यू नीड टू नोट डाउन एवरीथिंग एंड जस्ट चेक वेदर इट इज अवेलेबल और नॉट. सो शुड वी यूज इट और नॉट, दैट विल बी अप टू यू. आई विल हेल्प यू विजुलाइज दिस. इज देर एनी वर्ड रूट? यस, इट्स वन कार्बन एटम, सो विल बी यूजिंग मेथ. इज देर, यस, द प्राइमरी सफिक्स विल बी इन. Is there any secondary suffix? Is there any functional group? No. So here it will be termed as zero. As there is no functional group, primary prefix. Is there any cyclic chain? No. Nothing. No need to add. Is there any substituent left out? Something left out group or group, left out atom or group of atom? No. Again zero. So the only name which we come up with this molecule is meth plus ane. If you write them together, we obtain methane. So this is the name of this compound. Moving forward to two carbon atom. So now in this case, I have an alkane having two carbon atom. So you know the word root for alkane, that will be eth plus ane. So it will be ethane. Okay. Similarly, talking about propane, CH3, CH2, CH3. You know there are three carbon atoms. And you know these three carbon atom word root will be prop plus ane. Since there is a single covalent bond between carbon atoms, it will be called as propane. Let us take a case of four carbon atom. This will be bute plus ane, collectively called butane. Taking the case of 5 carbon atom, CH3, CH2, 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 CH3, it will be pent plus ane, collectively studied as pentane. Okay. So this is how we name our compound. These are the IUPAC name we are writing right now. You can also classify carbon atoms in alkane as primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary. So this is another way of classifying any carbon atom and hydrogen associated with these carbon atoms. So we can also classify carbon atom as primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary. So it is also written as 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree, 4 degree. Now, what is primary, secondary, tertiary? So basically, when your carbon atom is only attached to one carbon atom or no carbon atom, then it will be termed as primary. If it is attached to two carbon atom, it is called secondary. If it is attached to three carbon atom, it will be studied as tertiary carbon atom. If it is connected to four carbon atom, it will be called quaternary carbon atom. I will be drawing a molecule, so you will help me to understand which carbon atom is 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree, and 4 degree. Either you can say primary, secondary, tertiary, quaternary. Okay, so this is the molecule. Okay, let me change the color of pen. Now, look at this particular carbon atom. This is connected to only this carbon atom. So this is 1 degree. Now, this carbon atom is attached to 1, 2, and 3 carbon atom. This will be tertiary. Now this carbon atom is attached to 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 4 degree carbon atom. Now this carbon atom is attached to only two carbon atoms. So this is secondary carbon atom. Now this is again primary carbon atom. This is again primary carbon atom. And this is again primary carbon atom. Now hydrogen attached to primary carbon atom will be termed as primary hydrogen. This is secondary hydrogen. Remember, there is no quaternary hydrogen. Keep this in mind throughout your life. Again, this is primary hydrogen. Primary hydrogen. Tertiary hydrogen. Sorry. This is again primary hydrogen. Tertiary hydrogen. Primary hydrogen. I hope you have a better understanding of primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary. Okay, so moving on to alkenes. Now, if I talk about alkenes, how we are going to study them? See, we know that alkenes have carbon-carbon double bond between them. Okay, and we use suffix "ene" after word root in the case of alkene. And the general formula of alkene is CnH2n. Now this is the general formula of alkenes. We're trying to take help from these particular general formula to derive different members of alkenes. Now, your alkene were earlier called olefins. These were studied as olefins. Now, in the Greek, it is meant as oil forming. Okay? Because the lower members of these alkenes were earlier involved in formation of oily product when treated with chlorine. Now, the first case here we're taking as n equals to 1. Now let us use this formula now. When n equals to 1, C1H2 into 1. Remember, you can use this formula in your particularly alkane series also. Okay, so here this formula can again be used. For this case, n equals to 1. So if you put the n equals to 1, C1H2 into 1 plus 2, we'll be obtaining CH4. Similarly, you can obtain C2H6. How it will be done? Let us have a look. C2H2 into 2 plus 2. It will be C2H6. So I hope you can understand the use of these general formulas, how we are going to use them. So again, have a look at alkene series. If we take n equals to 1, we'll be obtaining CH2. Now here you can see the valency. It's not the octet is not complete and all valencies are not satisfied of this carbon atom. You can see two electrons are still free for bond formation, so this particular compound cannot exist. Nor you can see that there is any carbon-carbon double bond in this particular molecule. So this is not the case in the case of alkene. So the simplest alkene starts from n equals to 2. Now C2H2 into 2, it will be giving us C2H4. This is the simplest molecule of alkene, where two carbon atoms have double bond between them, and this is how hydrogen atoms are satisfying their valencies. And you can see this is how the first member of alkene looks like, and its name is again as per rule. You know, if there's two carbon atom, we'll be using eth, and as per rule, we'll be using primary suffix as ene. So eth plus ene gives ethene. Now we'll be taking the case of third one. We will be drawing the formula of n equals to 3. When you take n equals to 3, so formula becomes C3H6. What will be the particularly structure of this compound? CH3CH double bond CH2. Now this will be named as prop plus ene propene. You can also call it as 1-propene. Basically, 1-propene कहना सही नहीं होगा, बिकॉज अगर आप डबल बॉन्ड यहाँ से स्टार्ट करते हो तो भी ये 1-propene ही होगा, क्योंकि अब दोनों ही केस 1-propene होगा. सो यू डोंट नीड टू मैंशन इट इज़ 1 और नॉट, बिकॉज एट एनी केस योर डबल बॉन्ड इज स्टार्टिंग एट फर्स्ट कार्बन एटम ओनली. So no need to write one propane in the case of n equals in this particular case. Now n equals to 4, let us talk about this. It will be C4H8. Now how we can write the structure of this compound? First of all, we need to write 4 carbon atoms. Now we know that there's a need of double bond. Let us by default consider it as between 1 and 2 carbon atom. Okay, you can count, you suppose I'm counting it from this way, from this way. See, we'll be learning about rules, how to count. First of all, you need to understand ki we are just assuming ki main yahan se count kar raha hu. Now satisfying the valency, I have satisfied valency of this particular compound. While satisfying the valency of any carbon atom, you need to be very careful because sometimes we make mistakes. गलतियाँ सबसे होती हैं, मुझसे हो जाती हैं. That is not a big deal. तो कई बार मैंने भी अपने पढ़ाते वक्त मैंने ऐसा हुआ है कि मेरे से भी 5 कार्बन आटम, 5 वैलेंसी बन जाती है, 5 हाइड्रोजन आटम लगाता हूँ एक कार्बन के. तो इस गलती को मिनिमम रखने के लिए आपको स्ट्रांगली ऑब्जर्व करना है कि कैसे वैलेंसीज आपकी सेटिस्फाई हो. नाउ अब इसका नेम जो होगा वो 1, 2, 3, 4 ब्यूट प्लस इन, इट विल बी टर्म्ड एज ब्यूटीन. Now you know that this particular double bond is present starting from first carbon atom, so it will be termed as 1-butene. Okay. Now there is a possibility that double bond comes at this position. Am I right? So in that case, you need to mention the position of double bond. You can count from any way, 1, 2, 3, 4. So you know that this double bond starting at second carbon atom, so we'll be calling it as butuene or 2-butene. Here this 2 mentioning the position of double bond. Okay, so this is how we name our alkenes. I hope you are getting what I'm trying to tell you. Now we'll talk about alkynes. Now alkynes, you know, you all know that alkynes have carbon-carbon triple bond, and the suffix we use in alkyne is yne, Y-N-E. Okay. Now the general formula of alkyne is CnH2n-2. This is the general formula of alkyne. Now we need to have an idea about the first alkyne member. Let us take n equals to 1. In that case, put the value of n key value in this formula, and you will be coming it out of C1H0. It will be only C, that is only carbon. You can see here there is no carbon-carbon triple bond, there is no satisfaction of octet rule. So you can easily understand this is not the case which we were expecting. So this is not the first member. This won't be considered. The simplest member starts from second n equals to 2 value. Now C2H2 into 2 minus 2, it will be giving us C2H2. So this is the formula of first member. You know there is only 2 carbon atom, the word rule will be eth, and the primary suffix will be yne. So eth plus yne, it will be giving you ethyne. How this structure looks like, there's the 2 carbon atom having triple bond, and it is connected to further hydrogen atom to satisfy its valency. This is your propyne, sorry, this is your ethyne. Now we'll be looking forward for propyne. Propyne have 3 carbon atom, and this is a triple bond between 2 carbon atom, and accordingly valency is satisfied by hydrogen for rest of the carbon atoms. This will be prop plus ion, propyne. Okay, here C3H2 into 3 minus 2, it will be giving you C3H4. Easily see three carbon atoms are there and four hydrogen atoms are there. So this is how things goes on. This is your propane. Now let us have a look on butane. Butane have four carbon atoms between them. Okay, so I'm making the triple bond between first and second carbon atom. So that's the other will be satisfying the valency by hydrogen. So this is your butane. Okay, now there is a possibility that this triple bond comes here. Okay, just because of this, we need to mention whether it is one butane. So since starting from first carbon atom, we'll be calling it as one butane. Okay, now if carbon-carbon triple bond comes between second and third carbon atom, okay, in that case it will be 2-butane, because here you can see the triple bond is starting on second carbon atom. So this is how we name our hydrocarbons. I hope you got a general idea about naming of our hydrocarbons. In the upcoming lectures, we will be talking about some general rules which is required to name any compounds, and side by side you'll be getting more idea about how we are going to name a derivative of hydrocarbons. So basically when your hydrocarbon attached to functional groups, how we are going to name them. So you'll be having a general idea about that also. I hope you got a brief idea about my lecture. And if you like my lecture, do give a like on this video, do share with your friends, and do subscribe my channel. Thank you so much for watching this lecture. Take care.